but how will you know all circumstances under which you can or should train without being able to think about things that you would have never planned for? At Spalding, when I was teaching there in the master's program, we have an annual thing there called the rat race, and it's like a Kentucky Derby, but we have rats, and we train rats to run around a little Kentucky Derby.
Is this like a university event, or is this like a behavior analysis?
It's a university event.
Okay, so like all departments?
Program, yeah, each department and different programs get a rat, and then they train the rat. And first year of the program, obviously, you know, we killed it, we won the race.
Yeah.
Second year of the program, the students did a great job, and we had trained this rat, and we were doing a combination of clicker training and a little bit of luring, and basically just working on getting the rat to run around this whole loop, because rats are not really too into just running around a circle.
Yeah.
So we were doing good, and the training was going well. We had our rat doing fairly quick getting around. It's more about completing than the speed, because most of the rats don't even complete the circle.
Okay.
They just kind of stop and do their own rat things. They'll start digging in a corner and rearing up. And so we got this rat pretty well trained, and I thought, like, we're going in good. And of course, you know, we're the ABA department, so like, we kind of have to.
You better be performing well.
Yeah. So the students and I got together for rat race day, and we're ready to go. And last minute, they realized, so the rats actually, I forgot to mention, they start them in a gate. So the trickiest part of this training is getting the rat to leave the gate, because rats don't like to leave confined areas. It's kind of in, you know, their unlearned behavior to want to be in a confined space. It's very, so anyways, we did get our rat to do that and do pretty well. Then on the race day, we get all the rats out, and everybody's ready to go, and it's a big event, and people are cheering, and it's all exciting, and you know, and so all the students are like, yeah, we gotta win this, we gotta win again. And I'm like, yeah, we got this. I see what they were doing, and these guys don't know how to train a rat. You know? So they take our rat, and they had too many rats and not enough gates. They stuck our rat into a gate with another rat. And the two rats just sat there and started cleaning each other and grooming. And they pull the gate up, and the gate's open, and none of our rat and the other rat are just hanging out, you know, like just chilling. And some of the other rats start going, and we're all just like, go, come on. And the rat, neither of the rats ever left the gate. Yeah. And it was a pretty long race, because eventually some other rat finally made it around. And, you know, the students were not too happy about this. And I was kind of like, wow, that was a little bit of a disappointing factor. But I think the lesson from what I took out of this, and what I tried to encourage the students to see, is, yes, the environment controls behavior, but you don't always control the environment.
Yeah.
The circumstances under which you train are really relevant, but how will you know all circumstances under which you can or should train without being able to think about things that you would have never planned for? So I think that was part of the kind of moral, was try to plan for the disaster, try to plan for the not perfect scenario, because it's easy to teach programmatic targets, and it's easy to teach, especially in early intervention, to teach kids skills. But it's also probably a mistake to try to teach under such tight control that you're getting your data to look good and the skill is going up because that feels good to us.
Yeah.
But not to think about, well, how might this fail? What might not work well? How would I try to incorporate in training where things don't run perfectly?
Yeah.
And that was, I think, a pretty good learning experience.